horror movies. Something you guys by now know that I highly enjoy and love. So why are we talking about horror movies this time? Well, let's dive right into that. What is good, everybody? My Paper Moon fam, it's your boy Paper Sin, aka the Hokage of the village, getting in that loud, you feel me? And now before we get into this article on this horror movie that I'm looking forward to, I gotta make sure that you all remember, no matter what a stripper tells you, there is no sex in the champagne room. None.
No sex in the champagne room. No sex in the champagne room. No sex in the champagne room. No sex in the champagne room.
All right, let's go. So, apparently, H.P. Lovecraft's most iconic horror story is being adapted into a movie by James Wan. Yep, an H.P. Lovecraft short story is set to be adapted into a new horror movie from director James Wan, who helmed The Conjuring and Insidious. So, since it is a short story, I do wonder if they're going to be, are they going to try to put the entire story into the movie, or are they going to like try to extend it by adding random things that's not in the actual short story? Or like, you know what I'm saying? What's good? What's great? What's going on? No hate. But I'm curious. But yeah, let's get into the article. James Wan is officially making The Call of Cthulhu. The movie will be based on the iconic 1928 H.P. Lovecraft short story of the same name, which follows a man named Francis Thurston, who investigates a cult that seems to be involved in worshiping the ancient cosmic monster Cthulhu. The story is the first appearance of the iconic entity, who would later be referenced frequently in Lovecraft's work, as well as works by other prominent authors, including Robert Bloch and Stephen King. Deadline recently announced a batch of upcoming movies that are set to be adapted into video games, including the Garfield movie and Memory Lost in Space. Interesting. However, in announcing that James Wan's The Call of Cthulhu would be adapted into a game, the article effectively announced the movie itself. Oh, they gave themselves away. RIP. This summer, the director who previously helmed The Conjuring and Insidious stated that the title was his dream project, and one he'd been working on in the background for half a decade. I'm actually looking, you know, I'm looking forward to this. I'm pretty much looking forward to this. Cause damn, I forgot there was a game. I might have to play that. Oh no, I don't like playing horror games. I just like watching horror content. I might have to watch a let's play of it. I don't know, who knows? Maybe I will play it, but we'll see. But The Call of Cthulhu's adaptation history explained. Neither the James Wan movie nor its video game adaptation is the first time that Lovecraft's The Call of Cthulhu has been adapted into other formats, even on film. Lovecraft has been frequently adapted to the screen in movies ranging from 1960s classics The Haunted Palace and Die Monster Die to the 1980s effects extravaganzas, Reanimator, and From Beyond, to the more cerebral 21st century outing, Color Out of Space and Suitable Flesh. As one of his most popular and well-known stories, it is only natural that Cthulhu has been adapted several times since its publication nearly a year ago. So, I guess like, now we have to worry, is it going to be like beating a dead horse? Like, it's just another adaptation of a book that's been adapted a lot already. Should we be worried that it's not going to live up to the actual book and you know the other movies? Would the other movies outshine this movie? Is it going to be good enough? Or is it just going to be beating another dead horse? It's interesting to think about. But the article continues, the story was adapted into a variety of comic books throughout the 1960s, including Eerie, number 4, followed by other interpretations, including a tabletop game and an instrumental Metallica song. Ooh. However, the first time that it appeared on screen was in an episode of the animated show The Real Ghostbusters titled Let Call of Cthulhu, which loosely adapted the story. That was followed by a 2005 silent movie, The Call of Cthulhu, which is the only straightforward cinematic adaptation of the story thus far, though elements of the narrative are included in 2014's Call Girl of Cthulhu and 2020's Underwater. So I wonder what we're looking forward to here. Like, what are we gonna see? Are we gonna see a full adaptation, like the 2005 silent movie, or are we gonna see more like the loosely adaptation of it, which is like the Collect Call of Cthulhu or the Real Ghostbusters, the Real Ghostbusters? I'm curious. Like, let me know what you guys think in the comments below. The most widely known adaptation is likely the 2018 video game Call of Cthulhu. The game, which is an update of the 1981 role-playing game based on the story, was available on various platforms including Microsoft Windows, PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and Nintendo Switch. While it is unrelated to the one, The Call of Cthulhu, or its tie-in game, it proves that there is a viable market for new on-screen versions of the tale, both playable and cinematic. I don't know if I can agree with that, to be honest, because I don't know if there's a market for it now, because it's been adapted over and over and over again so many times that I'm not sure if people are going to care that there's another adaptation of it. There might be some diehard fans that are looking forward to it, but to gain a new audience, I'm pressing X to doubt. And yeah, I don't know, man. I don't know. But let me know what you guys think in the comments below, because did you play the 2018 video game? Did you enjoy it? Was it good? Also, what do you think about the other movies that were already, the other adaptations of the book that were adapted into movies? Like, did you watch those? Were they good? Are you even looking forward to this next adaptation? Or is it just like, oh, okay, another one? All right, well, whatever. Like, what's your stance on it? Let me know in the comments below. And yeah, that's all I got for now. So, hope you guys enjoyed this video and the article. So, the article was by... Hold on. Go up. Why isn't... Thank you, go up. The article was by Brennan Klein on ScreenRant.com. So shout out to you, Brennan. Thank you very much for your work. And yeah, let me know what you guys thinking about it in the comments below. Until then, don't forget to do those three things I'd like to ask you to do, and like, comment, and subscribe. And don't forget to hit the notification bell for more videos. Yeah. And you know what it is after that. In case I don't see you, baby. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and good night. Peace. Much love to you. Thank you.